Yes.
Final time in 2021, the Bethune Cookman University basketball team will take to the hardwood with the first ever season of SWAC conference play on the horizon. The Wildcats are looking to gain some momentum to close out the calendar year and potentially pick up a first Division I win of the season as well. Tonight's opposition comes from the Florida International University Panthers, who are in the midst of a mini program renaissance over the past 2 years, as the Panthers have made the four-hour trip up to Florida's East Coast for a Tuesday night showdown with the Wildcats.
And now, to honor America, please rise in the playing of our national anthem.
January, as the entire athletic program has left the MEAC after 40 years and set sail to join the Southwestern Athletic Conference starting this season. The Florida International Panthers come into the game at 5-3, and as I mentioned in the cold open, are in the middle of a miniature women's basketball renaissance over the past 2 years under head coach Jessica Burks Wiley. From a program that won just 11 games from fall 2018 to spring 2020 to 2 games above 500 last season at a consolation final victory in the Women's Basketball Invitational in March. The Panthers have taken the international in their name literally, with 8 of their 12 players born outside the United States, and have also dipped heavily into the transfer portal, with every player on the FIU roster that is not a freshman having started their college career at another institution. Now it's time for the players to keep a cat's eye on during tonight's contest. For FIU, it's guard Ariel Colon. While the grad transfer from Elon has not yet started a game for the Panthers this season, he does lead FIU in scoring with 14.1 points per game, at 3-point percentage with 35.7, and she leads the Panthers in steals as well with 15. Look for her to come off the bench and get right into the action in short order. And for Bethune-Cookman, it's Morgan Beecham, the Wildcats' only double-digit scorer, averaging 12.5 points, also the top assister on the team with 2.25 a game. The Orlando native has started every game this season for Bethune-Cookman. Lineups have been introduced here at Moore Gymnasium, and we're on the floor. For FIU, it's Kyla Nelson, Zaida Gonzalez, Raquel Ferrer-Bernard, Maria Torres, and I believe that is Emerald Ekpeteta. And for the Wildcats, Imani Reed starts. Morgan Beecham is in. Kayla White, as the tip is won by the Wildcats wearing the all-yellow. Let's play basketball. They attack the basket to listeners right. Immediately off the tip, it's controlled by Kayla White. She'll hand the ball off of a high screen. Bounce pass underneath to a backdoor cutting. Morgan Beecham, who lays it in, and BCU is on the board. Fast start for the Cats. Let's see how they choose to defend the up-tempo offense that FIU loves to employ. Here in the right wing corner, it's Kyla Nelson. And it cycles around into the hands of Raquel Ferrer-Bernard. And now Zaida Gonzalez. Right-hand corner. Yellow jerseys flying around to the basketball. They almost force a turnover. Kick out three to the left-hand corner. It bounces in from Raquel Ferrer-Bernard, native of Illeta, Spain. And now here's the full-court press from FIU. They will run this all the time and try and force turnovers with it. They'll back off as the Wildcats inbound. And here is Morgan Beecham going to run the offense for BCU. She's matched up with Gonzalez. Into the corner. Baseline drive. Layup too short. BCU wanted a foul. Won't get it. And here comes the native of Great Britain, Emerald Ekpeteta. She'll hand the ball off out high to Maria Torres. And now Gonzalez controls. Tight defense from BCU and forces Gonzalez to throw it away. And immediately FIU's gonna substitute. In comes Tanaya Hayes and Ariel Colon. So she wasn't on the bench for long, only a minute and a half in. And in comes the leading scorer for FIU. Once again, they'll play the full court press. And they'll back off when the Wildcats get it in to Morgan Beecham. Beecham across the time stripe, works to the right-hand corner and hands the ball off a screen to Taylor Williams, and a pass is intercepted by FIU. Here come the Panthers, going coast to coast. Is that Patetta? And a foul is called underneath. Emerald Ekpeteta is graduate transfer from Niagara College, but has a long playing career in England already, as she was part of the WNBL champion, Southport Pride. In 2016, they won the National Women's Championship in England as she hits the first of two free throws. Also has played with the, as hits them both, that it's a 5-2 lead for FIU. Ekpeteta also has played a little bit with the youth national teams for England. This time it's a different player running the point for the Wildcats. That's freshman Kayla White from Cleveland, Ohio. White, a float pass, baseline jumper. That'll be a long two. Good if it goes. It does not. And a battle for the rebound that leaves multiple players on the floor is won by the Golden Panthers. And now a foul is called in transition.
Don't gamble.
As Tanya White is... Tania White is bumped to the floor, but did not have position.
One below just to get it in.
So already two team fouls for the Wildcats. Going to have to watch that as they do not have as deep a roster as FIU does. FIU coming in with 12 players. Bethune-Cookman with only 10. So getting in foul trouble, not what you want. Left hand three, no good from Kayla Nelson. Underneath the basket, whistle and a stoppage. And they're going to get the foul on Maria Torres for FIU offensively, and the ball goes the other way to the Wildcats. It's really important for Bethune-Cookman to start fast tonight. They have let teams get big leads on them this season, for example, against North Florida. Last week, the Ospreys got up to a 10-0 lead before Bethune-Cookman even got on the board, and it was uphill sledding from there. The backcourt pressure doesn't faze Kayla White. She hands it off to Morgan Beecham. Beecham around a double screen. Almost loses the dribble, but stays with it. Here's a drive up and under and good for Morgan Beecham. On the baseline, and a foul is called again on the Wildcats. They're going to get this one on Kayla White. That'll be her first and the team's third. And Olivia Trice enters for the Panthers. Trice from basketball family. Her father played at Purdue and Butler. And all three of her brothers play college or professional ball. Underneath, they want it goes. FIU bench wanted a foul, won't get it. Here come the Wildcats in transition. White against a mountain. And travels the basketball. The Wildcats are going to have to be careful of FIU's height. They have four players listed at over 6 feet tall, whereas Bethune-Cookman only has the freshman, Kayla Clark, who is not in the basketball game. And Maria Torres listed at 6 foot one. She came out of the game now, replaced by Cologne. You just saw there how the height advantage can assist the Panthers. Golden Panthers with a one-point lead as they cycle the ball around, looking for a way to get inside the paint. Here's Cologne. Cologne around a screen, into the paint, and a foul. That was an aggressive move to the basket. And that'll be on Morgan Beecham.
E, get your shoes. Get your shoes.
And in a preseason interview with the Cat Eye Network, Coach Clayton said that her goal for the team was to play at a fast pace. And we're seeing that a little bit here, but maybe to the Wildcats' detriment. As the first of a pair of free throws is good for Cologne. And now we will see the only player on this Bethune-Cookman roster that is over 6 feet tall, the 6'3 freshman Kayla Clark. Who comes in for Bethune-Cookman. Kayla from Miami, standout at Miami Central and a two-time All-Star in high school. And she will match up with Hope Butera as a turnover off the inbounds pass goes FIU's way. Quick three from the corner, left it short, did Olivia Trice. Wildcats down three early in the first quarter. Into the corner, here's Beecham. Posting up on the baseline is Tania White. White trying to get space for a layup. He eventually decides to shoot a mid-range jump shot under pressure, and it's too strong. Aggressive out to the sideline and a foul underneath as Olivia Trice drove coast to coast. Taylor Williams picks up the foul. I mentioned that Trice All three of her brothers play collegiate and professional ball, and her dad played at Purdue and Butler. But she has a very impressive resume as well. All-Western Ohio Conference team three times in high school. Played her first two seasons of college ball at Bowling Green State before going down south to Miami. She sinks one of two. Second free throw up and good, and it's a five-point lead for the Panthers. Into the game, Camry Harris, the senior guard, will inbound the ball into the press. Double team comes, Harris gets it back, and eventually it finds the hands of Beecham. Beecham into the corner, and a travel, as taking one too many steps was Tatum Hayes, the junior guard from Fort Myers. Turnovers hurting BCU early. Already the third on the Cats. Golden Panthers control. Three on the way off to the left from Tania Hayes. And controlling for the Wildcats is Harris. Harris into the offensive zone, double teamed, and a tie-up. And the possession arrow favors FIU. Excellent work. Quick hands on the defensive end to turn the ball over again. We've seen this FIU defense early on be very aggressive, trying to force turnovers, and it's worked. Be it via BCU mistakes. Here's Cologne for three, in and out. And it goes out of bounds, BCU basketball. We've seen FIU force Bethune-Cookman into mistakes as Raquel Ferrer-Bernard comes back into the game for FIU. First two college seasons at Casper College in Wyoming. That's a bit of a change from Miami, and a timeout going to be called by the Wildcats. They could not get the ball in due to the FIU press, and it will be a quick timeout. Well, you can follow Bethune-Cookman women's basketball on Twitter at BCU WBB for in-game updates, including links to live coverage and more. This is the 16th meeting between the FIU Panthers and the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats in women's basketball. FIU leads the overall series 10-5, but BCU did get the better of them in 2019, 65-60. Wildcats to inbound against the high press behind the defenses. Beecham. Beecham drives to the lane, gets fouled and one. And there you see the speed and elusiveness of Morgan Beecham as she snuck behind the FIU press and raced to the basket, and she'll get the first chance at the line for the Wildcats tonight. And a beautiful pass off the inbound by Camry Harris to find Beecham in space. A three-time district title winner at West Orange High School is Beecham. In and out goes the free throw. And with 5:23 to go in the first quarter, it's a 9-6 lead for FIU. And a reach-in foul out high for Beecham. And that's really not which a foul you want to give. Back to the basket almost at the halfway line. Ariel Colon will come in, and Beecham will also come in. Kayla White, the freshman, replaces her. White leads the Wildcats in steals this season with 12. And into the bonus go FIU. So this will be a 1+1 for Raquel Ferrer Bernard.
One shot for Bernard.
Swished both of the free throws, and it's 11-6. Harris gets it in short to Tatum Hayes. Hayes racing past the defense, finds Kayla Clark, and Clark will reset to White. White trying to go to her left hand to get around the screen, draws a double team. It quickly cycles into the corner for Harris. Her three is good from Camry Harris. Yeah. 11-9, FIU on top. Right hand wing to a baseline drive. Here's Gonzalez underneath. Whistle and stepping on the baseline is Gonzalez. And Wildcats will take the ball with a chance to tie the game. And the 6'1", Maria Torres will check back in. She replaces Hope Butera. Butera, the tallest listed player on the FIU roster at 6'3", matching Kayla Clark. That's going to be a fun one-on-one matchup to watch tonight. Zaida Gonzalez also departs for FIU. Another long pass finds the hands of Kayla White. Her running layup is good, and the FIU Panthers have been beat by that long lob pass twice this quarter, and we have a tie ball game.
Move it! Move the ball!
Grace Hunter freshly into the game, wearing number 5 for FIU. Quick three from the left-hand corner is no good, and the ball bounces out of bounds. Bethune-Cookman will control. Grace Hunter, a junior, transferred over from South Plains College in Texas. In the ball goes. It's controlled by Tania White. And the Panthers back off as across the time stripe comes Kayla Harris. White. As FIU settles into a 2-3 zone. It goes to the left-hand corner. Tatum Hayes a three. Rims out. And FIU takes the board. The shortest player on the floor, Bernard, takes the board. In transition, a baseline drive, shuffled to the right-hand corner. Hunter puts up a floater. Back iron no good. Offensive board for Maria Torres. Gets a third opportunity at it. That one got tipped on the way up. And the rebound is pulled down by Kayla Clark. Here comes the fast pace from the Wildcats once again. Is getting to the paint and losing the handle is Kayla White, and it'll be FIU ball. Sadie Harrell enters the game for the first time for the Wildcats. A freshman from Connors, Georgia. All-state performer in high school, regional and county player of the year as a senior.
Look at Kyla. Kyla, call for the ball.
Ball movement around the perimeter for FIU, 3:20. To go first quarter, and a foul over the back as that's Tatum Hayes tapping the attacker on the arm.
Kyla. Kyla,
that's already the fifth team foul on the Wildcats. That'll be two shots for Trice. Averaged just over 3 points
Knock this down.
At Bowling Green, her freshman and sophomore seasons combined. First free throw missed, second one swish. And Ekpeteta returns for Florida International. The press comes again. Now FIU will back off. White loses the handle, got to get across the time stripe. She does. Gets the ball to her left hand. Hands off to Hayes. And now Harrell. White to the corner, a three on the way, airballed it too strong, but the rebound comes down to Clark, and they're gonna reset the shot clock to 8 seconds and give the Wildcats the ball. It was a three-pointer from the right-hand corner from Camry Harris. Looked like she had a good look at it, but missed it long, but the long arms of Kayla Clark saved the possession for the Wildcats, and we continue with this offensive possession. With BCU down by one, 2:50 to go, opening quarter. Through a double team, 2 seconds on the shot clock. White's gonna put it up, back iron, too strong, another offensive rebound, up, and a foul on Kayla Clark. That's Ekpatetta's first foul, and Kayla Clark's gonna go to the line, averaging a team best 7.7 rebounds per game. The freshman center from Miami. And she gets to the free throw line a lot as she hits the first one to tie the game. Two bounces and a spin of the basketball. Front iron and no on the second, so it remains a 12-12 game.
Got her! Shoot it, Kyla.
FIU continuing to cycle the ball around the perimeter. The zone defense of the Wildcats allowing nothing in the paint. So far, open, three on the way, too strong. Olivia Trice missed that one as the rebound goes out of bounds. It'll be FIU ball over the baseline.
The ball belongs to the Wildcats.
I mentioned before that Kayla Clark gets to the line a lot. She is 17 of 26 at the line this season, as it actually is BCU ball. That's 65.4% at the charity stripe. Another long inbounds pass. White gets it, goes up, hits the layup over to Nyjah Hayes. And that is another layup in transition for Kayla White off a long inbounds pass. That's the third for the Wildcats so far. Drive and kick, baseline. Trice couldn't get one, and a foul is going to be called as a left-hand layup is no good by Emerald Ekpatetta, and that'll be on Kayla Clark, her first personal.
Matchup.
14 all with a minute 53 to go in this first quarter. Glad you could join me for this Tuesday night edition of Bethune-Cookman Wildcats Basketball, the Cat Eye Network. My name is Michael Trullillo.
Let's go, talk!
Free throw is good.
Talk left!
And a one-point lead for FIU.
Go middle, E, take one, E. Shooter, E.
Kayla White.
Shooter, E. There you go, good. Quick.
Working hard on the outside against Tanisha Hayes. Looking for a pass, now got to move the ball. It's tapped away by Trice, but going back to recover is Camry Harris. Harris working in front of the FIU bench. Got to pass the ball up, and it's going to be a shot clock violation. And FIU's defense does its job and turns the ball over once again. FIU is up by one. They're only 2 of 12 from the field.
That's fine.
Got their work done at the line. Backdoor pass to Ekpatetta and got it blocked. Three on the way after the offensive rebound. Grace Hunter left it short. And now foul called underneath.
You guys got the call. You got the call.
Imani Reed, the junior from Columbia, Maryland, comes into the game for the Wildcats. As it was not a foul, my apologies. It's the out-of-bounds possession to FIU. Minute 5 to go in the opening quarter. Trice thought about a shot. Now works on Harris. Ball in the left hand of Grace Hunter, gets to the lane, and carrying violation is called. And it'll be Wildcats possession.
Come on.
Ariel Cologne, the top scorer for the FIU Panthers back into the game. She shoots 35.7 from beyond the arc as well. Under a minute to go, first quarter. Tatum Hayes controls, gets to the baseline, mid-range jumper in and out. That's an unfortunate roll for Hayes. That was a good look. Here's Ekpeteta. Behind the back dribble from Hayes. Tries to get into the paint with a little Euro step action. Offensive rebound from Ekpeteta. Rims out and the Wildcats control on the board from Sadie Harrell. Long pass ahead to Hayes. Hayes into the paint. Right hand layup. Just rims out. Good defense that time by Kyle Nelson, the other Brit on the FIU roster.
Skip!
Cologne.
Move it!
Moves it back out on top to Nyjah Hayes. The freshman guard, 5 seconds, fires a mid-range jumper, no good. 2-1, and that will end the opening quarter of play. Back and forth action we go with more gymnasium. It's 15-14, FIU leads BCU. We'll take a short break and be right back. This is Bethune-Cookman Wildcats women's basketball on the Cat Eye Network. After sitting out the entire 2020 and 21 season, it is so good to have Bethune-Cookman Wildcats Athletics back on the floor. It is 15-14. Florida International leads Bethune-Cookman as we start the second quarter here at historic Moore Gymnasium. My name is Michael Torillo. Thank you for joining me on the Cat Eye Network. It's a steal by Ekpeteta. Goes coast to coast. Lays it up. Left hand rolls in. FIU wanted a kickball and a travel, neither called. Into the paint for a floater. No good from Imani Reed, the junior from Columbia, Maryland. Ekpeteta running the paint. Tries to do it herself, kicks it out to the left-hand corner, and it's taken away. Going coast to coast with a right-hand layup is Kayla White. Kayla White, 3 of 4 shooting. 6 points. It'll be to Nyjah Hayes, the freshman, to control. Coughs up the basketball. Just lost it on the dribble. And White controls for BCU. White. Right hand drive. Hands it off for a traveling violation against Camry Harris as she took one too many steps before placing the ball down. Into the game again for the Wildcats comes their top scorer, Morgan Beecham, also the leader in assists and blocks. as she replaces Kayla White. White's done a fantastic job in Beecham's absence because Beecham has two fouls. In the hands of Bernard right now for FIU. Open three in the corner, rattles out. And neither team really having success from deep tonight. Here's Beecham. Tries to get around a screen, but has to force it to Harris. Harris hands the ball off to Imani Reed. It's a 10 on the shot clock. Driving into the paint. Contact and a foul. Nice drive by Imani Harris, or Camry Harris. They're going to get Ferrer Bernand on the foul, so that's number one on number one. And first team foul of the quarter for FIU. Into the line goes Camry Harris. Hers is her first trip to the line of the season. And misses that one off to the right. Harris from Suffolk, Virginia. An area that I know pretty well. Up and good on the second. And it's a tied ball game once again. It's 17, 8 minutes to go in the second quarter. Bernard. Against a little bit of a zone look from the Wildcats. Quickly into the corner. Three on the way, in and out. Olivia Trice couldn't get that one to fall. And you can see the FIU strategy of cycle around the perimeter to hit open threes, but they're just not falling right now for the Panthers. Nice backdoor cut. The ball is shuffled underneath the basket, and Imani Reed couldn't pick it up off the ground. Nice little 1-2 pass, but Reed couldn't corral it. It will still be Wildcat ball. Camry Harris, the gunner. Harris looking for an opening. Whistle and a stoppage of play. And they're going to get Ferrer Bernard for a push off the ball. As Tanija Hayes comes back in. Freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina, Hayes. Harris, bounce pass underneath the basket, spinning in the lane. A wild layup is good from Tania White. How about that? From White through the contact and gives the Cats the lead. Out on top. It's Tanija Hayes. Hayes posting up around the screen and a nice backdoor find for Emerald Ekpeteta. That was just a little bit of an overcommitment there from the Wildcats on defense, and Ekpeteta made him pay. Ekpeteta up to 9 points. Into the lane, an offensive foul, and that's going to be another on Morgan Beecham. Unless they call that on Imani Reed. No, it is going to be on Beecham. So her third foul to the bench. Beecham goes again, replaced by Kayla White, and White has done a terrific job in place of Beecham, who's had foul trouble today.
15 side, we're good.
Cologne, freshly into the game, the top scorer for FIU, finds Maria Torres.
AC, you're supposed to pop to the wing.
Kyla Nelson, the Brit, from Worthing, England, switches to her left hand. Up against Clark, up and under, no good, and Clark gets the board and a foul on the breakout. There are two players down, one from each team. And they're going to call the foul on Tennille White as she knocked Maria Torres to the ground off the ball. A howl from the BCU bench as they thought the foul should have gone the other way, but FIU gets an extra possession here with 6:22 to go in the first half and a 19-all ball game. Defensive contest for the most part thus far. Nelson against White. Nelson, and underneath the basket pass finds Maria Torres. Torres, another native of Spain. She's from Madrid. Played at Colorado State to start her college career. Long pass ahead. Finds Tatum Hayes, and now back to Kayla White. White into a double team, has to get rid of the basketball, and she does, but it's into the hands of Olivia Trice for FIU. Panthers with numbers. To the baseline goes Trice, and she'll kick it back out, and the Panthers will start their offense with Cologne wearing that silver brace on her left knee. Left-hand corner, baseline drive after she got her defender in the air. Trice's bucket rims out, and a block underneath as Torres tried for the putback. And it's going to be Wildcats ball on the breakout. Sadie Harrell back into the game, and a Hope Butera. It was an interesting summer for Hope Butera. She played for the Rwandan senior national team at this year's AfroBasket qualifiers. Unfortunately, Rwanda failed to qualify for the main event, but a fantastic learning experience playing some senior-level international basketball. 21-19, the visitors lead at Moore Gymnasium. Backdoor pass, up and under, too short on the layup for Camry Harris. The FIU bench wants a little bit of pace. Cologne against Hayes. Cologne puts her shoulder into Hayes, and a layup is too strong, out of bounds. Wildcat ball. Zaida Gonzalez back in, a freshman from West Palm Beach, as we will take immediate timeout with under 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. We'll take 30 seconds and be right back. This is Bethune-Cookman Women's Basketball on the Cat Eye Network. Well, the Wildcats have a new head coach this year as Janelle Creighton takes over from Vanessa Blair Lewis. Creighton, a native of Atlanta, this is her first head coaching job, but she has been an assistant as a who's who of colleges in the Southeast, including Kennesaw State, UNC Asheville, William & Mary, Colgate, Oberlin, and Oglethorpe. And she actually had the opportunity to teach basketball in Ghana before coming back to the States to take over the BCU program. Wildcats to inbound. Tatum Hayes gets the ball in. Double team trap. Harris got to get rid of the basketball. Almost turns it over. Kayla White does manage to get it, but it's going to be a 10-second violation as the FIU full court press works its magic, and it's another Panther turnover. Well, another Panther forced turnover for Bethune-Cookman.
Our ball underneath.
Triangle two left.
Creighton played her collegiate career at Dayton and then had a couple of years of professional ball in the Czech Republic and Turkey. Catch and shoot off the inbounds. Too strong on the three from Trice, but an offensive board for the Panthers, and they keep it going. Whistle off the ball. And the head referee, Tasha Smith, is going to come over here to talk to the scorers table. Camry Harris departs. Taylor Williams, the transfer from across town at Daytona State, comes into the ball game. Williams, a junior, originally from Rahway, New Jersey. Just a 2-point advantage for FIU here with 4:28. to go in the opening half of play. Driving baseline and coughing up the ball is Kyla Nelson. Here come the Wildcats in transition. Kayla White will slow it down. And she will receive it back from Sadie Harrell. Harrell maybe had space for a three, doesn't take it. A drive, a floater, a good from Kayla White. Kayla White up to three steals on the night. She leads the team in steals with 12, 1.5 a game, and you know that number is going to be going up after a performance of this first half. Tie ball game at 21. An errant pass goes out of bounds into the Bethune-Cookman bench, and it'll be a chance to take the lead for Bethune-Cookman, who have kind of hung on the coattails of FIU in this half, considering that FIU is only 5-for-27 from the field. And Bethune-Cookman hasn't really been able to pull away. Nice spin move. Another floater for White. Off the foot of the rim and good. Kayla White up to 10 points. Baseline drive. Wide open look. Won't take it. Does Gonzalez. And she gets it back to Nelson. Hayes. Nice speed to blow by a defender, but it's back iron no good. She gathers her own miss. Three on the way from Trice. Another back iron no good as FIU cannot get anything to fall. Lid on the basket for the ladies in blue and gold. Wildcats a chance to extend their two-point advantage. Under three to go in the half. White thought about a three, but chooses to drive instead. The ball is in and out of the hands of Taylor Williams, picked up by FIU. It rolls all the way out of bounds across the Wildcat baseline, but it was deflected by Bethune-Cookman, so it will stay Panther basketball. A little bit of a scrappy sequence there from both sides, but FIU has a chance to tie the game here. The gunner is Zayda Gonzalez. At the free throw line, here's Ekpeteta. And a three on the way from straight on from Gonzalez is no good. Rebound to BCU. Shoveled back to Harrell. Harrell bounce pass, baseline jumper too strong from Taylor Williams. Recovered by the Panthers, and a falling down in transition is Clark. Quick numbers advantage from FIU. They do not attack the basket. And they will just have Olivia Trice hold with it at the top. To the corner. A nice baseline drive. Reverse layup is good for Kyla Nelson, the captain of the Great Britain U16 and U18 women's national teams. Is Nelson splitting a double team into the front court. Here comes Tatum Hayes, reverses course and hands the ball back to Taylor Williams. Free throw line out to Harris. Her three-pointer, bang from Camry Harris. And back on top by three goes BCU. A minute and a half to go first half. Camry Harris on point from beyond the arc tonight. Here's a baseline drive from Zayda Gonzalez. Over the baseline it goes, and it's Wildcat basketball. FIU wanted a foul, didn't get it. Tanaja Hayes into the game for FIU. Hayes, the top assist getter for the Panthers. And not really playing trap this time is FIU. They'll just kind of play a half-court press. And now the Wildcats get it into the front court. 1 minute to go in the first half. On the floor, nice drive, and a ball is blocked on a layup from Harris. Nice baseline cut by Harris. It was a better block by Ekpeteta. Harris to the wing, a three, swish, it's good from Olivia Trice, and she finally cashes in. Only one of 12 from deep are the Golden Panthers, or excuse me, the Panthers in this first half. Gotta get rid of the ball. Does Harris, she does, to Clark. Clark trapped in front of the FIU bench, throws it back to Harris. Harris with 8 seconds to go in the half. Here's Hayes from three, no. And FIU a chance within transition with 8 seconds left, and a running layup is good for Olivia Trice. Olivia Trice. Continued to run.
We got sub here.
For the last couple of seconds of the game, in comes Maria Torres. Torres played her club basketball for Rivas Parque Sureste in Madrid. FIU gonna have a chance to increase their 2-point lead. 1.2 seconds to go, up and under, no. And we go to the break. The score, Florida International 28, Bethune-Cookman 26, in a enthralling contest here at Moore Gymnasium. It's Ekpateta with 9, Trice with 8, Ferrer Bernard with 5, and Nelson, Torres, and Cologne each with 2 for the Golden Panthers. And for Bethune-Cookman, it's the freshman, Kayla White, who leads the team with 10 points, 7 for Harris, 6 for Beecham, but she also has 3 fouls, 2 for Tania White, and 1 for Clark. We'll take a break for about 15 minutes and then be back for the second half of action from the historic Moore Gymnasium. Your score at the break, Bethune-Cookman 26, FIU 28. live from historic Moore Gymnasium on the campus of Bethune-Cookman University. The second half of action between the Florida International Panthers and the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats is about to get underway. Hello and a very warm welcome back to the action. My name is Michael Gimeno. Thank you so much for being with me on this Tuesday evening for some college basketball non-conference State of Florida action. Well, BCU, as I mentioned late in the first half, has been kind of riding the coattails of the FIU Panthers. The Panthers have had the lead for most of the game, with the Wildcats lagging just slightly behind. They did take the lead off a couple of three-pointers by Camry Harris late in the first, but Florida International got the last couple of buckets to close the half on top. BCU has gotten advantage of the poor outside shooting from FIU. The Panthers only shooting 24.2% from the floor. That's 8 for 33 and 2 of 13 from beyond the arc. Conversely, the Cats are 45% from the field and 40% from three. Raquel Ferrer-Bernard controls for the Panthers. They attack the basket. Two viewers right in the second half. Ball bumped out of bounds by Kayla White. Kayla White, 10 points in the first half. The freshman mostly on in relief for Bethune-Cookman. Top scorer Morgan Beecham, who has three fouls. Well, I'm sure we will see Beecham at some point during this second half. Bernard underneath the basket. It goes Ekpateta, easy as you like, off the glass. Nice find on the baseline feed from Bernard. Wildcats got to get it over the timeline. They did take 10-second violation in the first half. White, dangerous pass, does find Imani Reed. Beecham to the corner, stepping inside, a long two is on the way, in and out from Taylor Williams.
Go, all the corner, live, call for it.
Long pass under the basket. Outside it goes, three on the way, swish for Kayla Nelson. Or excuse me, Kyla Nelson. And Nelson has given the Panthers a 33-26 lead, a quick 5-point swing off the opening for FIU of this second half. Against the double team to the baseline. A layup is too strong for Tania White. Put back, foul, and one! How about that for Imani Reed? Imani Reed scores her first points of the night in style, picking up the offensive board and laying it back up and in through contact. As the foul, I'm waiting for the live stats update so I can know who the foul is on. The foul is on Nelson, her first. The and one is swish. And a nice 3-point play to give the Wildcats some life in this third quarter, 33-29. They trail the FIU Panthers. Across the timeline, Raquel Ferrer-Bernard, the senior from Lleida, Spain. Excellent defensive intensity from Kayla White. 10 on the shot clock now. White continues to have Bernard. She gets it away to Nelson. Nelson with two, fires a three, it's good. Clutch shot at the end of the clock, and Kyla Nelson, has another three. FIU hot shooting to start the second half. They lead 36-29, their largest lead of the contest. Here's Morgan Beecham in after sitting most of the first half after picking up three quick fouls. Wearing the number four, White controls now. White, that's a wild shot, but an offensive rebound is up and good from Taylor Williams. Williams played her freshman season at Pensacola State, and then her sophomore season across town at Daytona State. Around the screen, Nelson does not hit a third three of the quarter. That one rims out short. The rebound comes down to Tania White. White coast to coast lays it in. Off the nice backdoor feed. Taylor Williams actually catches it on it. Off the nice feed from White. And it's a three-point game. As the crowd here at Moore Gymnasium starts to come to life a little bit. Three on the way from Trice, so way too strong, but the offensive board comes out to Bernard. Three on the way, rattles home from Bernard, and the FIU Panthers have found their shooting stroke to start this second half. Up to 27% shooting from three for the game. Into the lane is White, gets it blocked by Maria Torres. And the Wildcats will keep the ball. And this is what I expected to see from FIU in the first half. They came out a little slow, allowed Bethune-Cookman to hang around. But now, they've got the three-point shooting going. And now the Wildcats are trying to hang on. Down 33-39. Here's Taylor Williams. Williams, careful not to travel, hands it to Kayla White. White to the corner, three on the way. It's short from Taylor Williams. And another Panther board. Nelson. Trice back to Nelson. Gets a screen from Torres. Gets around it to the paint, up and under, off the underside of the rim, no good. And a rebound pulled down by Kayla Clark, the freshman for the Bethune-Cookman. Ball on the ground. It rolls out of the hands of Taylor Williams. And FIU comes away with it. And off the scramble, Ekpeteta underneath for the lay-in on a nice feed from Nelson. The English connection. Ekpeteta from London. Nelson, from Worthing, England. Looking for something on the offensive side, and they'll get a foul. As Tania White pops to her feet after drawing the contact. That'll be Nelson's second personal, and it's going to be kind of important for Bethune-Cookman to get her off the floor, because she has been shooting lights out. And something interesting for those of you who are not down at the scores table, the FIU coaching staff has written down the names of the referees, the three referees, and has taped it to the scores table.
Just gotta step out a half step on it.
So they can refer to the referees by name. I don't think I've ever seen that before. First penalty shot is up and good from White. And the Wildcats close to within seven. Second one is also good. 6-point lead for the Panthers. Panthers 3-5 on the season have played the majority of their games at home at the Ocean Bank Convention Center in Miami. Underneath the basket, the ball is tipped and knocked away. And now a clean steal from Tanaja Hayes on the breakout. I think that's going to be a held ball. The possession arrow should favor Bethune-Cookman. And getting up gingerly is Taylor Williams in yellow. It'll be a jump ball after the media timeout. We'll take a minute and be right back. It's 41-35 FIU. This is Bethune-Cookman Wildcats women's basketball on the Cat Eye Network. Thank you. Well, you can visit our website. It's your one-stop shop for all things Wildcat Athletics. Visit bcuathletics.com for stats, schedules, and all relevant information about every Bethune-Cookman Wildcat team. 41-35, it's the FIU Panthers over the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats. 4:51 to go third quarter. It's been a tight contest so far. The Panthers just beginning to stretch their legs a little bit with Emerald Ekpeteta up to 13 points to lead all scorers for FIU. Bethune-Cookman off the jump ball. They control the possession arrow, so they'll start with it. Here's White, hands to Tatum Hayes. Hayes back to White, through a double team, passes it. A floater in the lane, off the glass, hangs on the rim, not good, and a foul's gonna be underneath. And it's going to be Emerald Ekpeteta. Second personal foul for Ekpeteta. Wildcats control. 4:30 to go. Swung all the way out up top and saving it barely from going over the time stripe is Tinia White. White sets the screen for Kayla White to go. Bounce pass, backdoor cutter. No good. That was put on a platter for Tatum Hayes. She couldn't finish it. The other way. Passing out of a double team. And now underneath the basket, out for an open look. Three is off the mark, too short. Falling out of bounds is Taylor Williams. It'll be FIU ball as the crowd here at Moore Gymnasium wanted a foul there, but none called. And so it'll be FIU to inbound under the basket that they attack. All the way up it goes to Nelson. In the post, here's Butera. And now Zaida Gonzalez. Gonzalez draws a double team. Nice slip pass and good ball movement, finding Nelson in the corner for three. Nelson up to 11 to join the fellow Englishwoman Emerald Ekpeteta in double-digit scoring for FIU. Ekpeteta with 13, Nelson with 11. And it's a 9-point FIU lead. Baseline drive, and it's poked away from Tania White. And Wildcats control after it was knocked out of bounds by Maria Torres. Torres only played 8 games at Colorado State, the 6'1 Spaniard. Almost poked away from Taylor Williams. Step back three off to the left from Tania White. Looking to go coast to coast was Hayes, and an offensive foul as Tania Hayes rumbled through a Wildcat underneath.
Hey, good effort, Blue. Good effort, Blue. Shooter.
As Camry Harris checks in for the Wildcats, she replaces Kayla White. Also Sadie Harrell. And one thing I will give Coach Janelle Creighton credit for in this young season with Bethune-Cookman, she gets her players into the game. Doesn't matter if you're a freshman through a senior. All players on this Bethune-Cookman squad are averaging double-digit minutes. As Hope Butera checks in, replacing Torres. Press broken for the Cats. And Taylor Williams controls. On the BCU logo against her opposite number, Tanaja Hayes. To the left-hand corner. Nice athletic work by Hayes to stay with her. Here's Tatum. Driving inside, wild layup on the baseline, won't go for Sadie Harrell. And a rebound pulled down by FIU. Nice work by Ekpeteta. Ekpeteta across, and in front of the FIU bench, Gonzalez slows it down and gets it to Hayes. Hayes underneath the basket, and a foul is gonna be called. Hope Butera taking advantage of that 6-3 frame to try and put the ball up and under. Didn't get the layup, but did get the foul. Ferrer Bernard comes back, and we will have a timeout.
Media timeout.
We'll take 30 seconds and be right back. It's an 11-point lead for the FIU Panthers. This is Bethune-Cookman Women's Basketball on the Cat Eye Network. Follow Bethune-Cookman Women's Basketball on Instagram for the best moments from BCU Athletics at BCU_WBB. Florida International extends the lead to 11 and have outscored Bethune-Cookman 16-9 so far in this third quarter, mostly from the hot shooting of Kyla Nelson and Emerald Ekpeteta, both in double digits now for the Panthers. And it will be the native of Kigali, Rwanda, Hope Butera, at the line for two as we get back to action. I mentioned Butera played for the Rwandan senior national team at this year's AfroBasket qualifiers and played her first two collegiate seasons at the junior college level for South Georgia Tech. Against the press. Here's Beecham across the time stripe. And it's controlled by Taylor Williams. Williams trying to get around Bernard. Gets to the hoop. Gets the harm, but not the bucket. So it'll be two shots. That'll be Ferrer Bernard's foul. BCU hasn't been good from the free throw line. Well, they're even with FIU. Neither team has been great from the line. 14 of 36. Oh, no, excuse me, that's field goals. From the line tonight, BCU is only 5 of 8. Make that 6 of 9 as the first one falls down for Taylor Williams. Williams' two siblings, Chris and Elijah, and had a season-high 17 points in the season opener in this building against Edward Waters. Back within 10 are the Cats, 46-37, and now BCU decides to play some pressure here. Bernard into the front court, around the screen set by Butera. Kayla White has played some fantastic one-on-one defense, but this is Taylor Williams guarding the ball. Now it's Nelson. And Bernard into the painted area, back to a pass, blocked, but a foul. Almost a clean block that time by Clark, but her hand just rolled onto the wrist of Hope Butera.
Hey, way to play together. Way to play together, Blue. Good job.
And something I've noticed about FIU in this second half is their passing has been a lot faster, and they must have stressed that in the locker room at halftime. It's nice. Instead of waiting for something to happen in front of them, it's 1-2, play to open space, fire teammate cutting, off-ball movement very important. And that has really been the main catalyst that has allowed the Panthers to increase this lead in the third quarter. Minute 40 left in it, and it's a 10-point lead for the ladies in blue and gold. Beecham has been in the entire second half, the top scorer for Bethune-Cookman, but has not really made that much of an impact so far in this third quarter. Beecham against Bernard, decides to take the shot too strong. An excellent box out by Butera to control the board. Bernard. Pick and pop for Bernard. Swish, it's good. Raquel Ferrer Bernard. As she's up to 8 points. And it's 50 for FIU. Baseline pass to Tatum Hayes. Out over the baseline, deflected by Ek Pateta, so it'll be Wildcats ball. Excuse me, with that three, Bernard up to 11 points, joining Nelson.
Get around me!
Under a minute to go, third quarter. And a offensive foul is going to be called as an illegal screen set by Tatum Hayes. Knocks Bernard to the ground. Tanaja Hayes, a freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina, Zebulon B. Vance High School, averaged 12.3 points and 5.2 assists her senior year, and she controls right now for the Panthers. I have been very impressed by Hayes tonight and the amount of freedom that the FIU coaching staff has given her to run the offense. Hayes around the defender, gets the foul, does not get the roll off the front of the iron. And they're going to get the foul on Sadie Harrell. And already the fourth team foul of the quarter. So two shots upcoming for Tanaja Hayes. Leads the Panthers in field goal percentage, right on 50%. Assists with 19 and steals with 15. Those are all numbers from before the game. Spins the ball at her right hand and gets the second free throw to go. 51-37. As the Panthers have doubled up the Wildcats in this quarter, 23-11 the score.
Good talk.
15 seconds, the Wildcats will likely hold for the final shot, but a held ball. It's going to be FIU ball. Excellent work by Tanaja Hayes on the tie-up to get Taylor Williams. Looks like she almost dribbled it off her foot, and then Hayes tied her up. Nelson with six. High ball screen into a double team for Nelson. Passes out of it underneath, and a block will end the third quarter. Nice block by Kayla Clark underneath. But it's all Golden Panthers in the third frame. 51 for FIU, BCU 37. We'll see if the Wildcats can fight back in the fourth quarter next. This is BCU Women's Basketball on the Cat Eye Network. winner of that Bethune-Cookman basketball will be back at Historic Moore Gymnasium tomorrow night at 7 p.m. as the men's basketball team faces the Johnson University Suns. Coverage on Cat Eye Network begins at 7 p.m. and attendance is free at Moore Gymnasium. Well, FIU used 5 3-pointers in the third quarter to pull away. They lead 51-37. Mid-range jumper good. The Cats needed that from Morgan Beecham. Three three-pointers in the third quarter hit by Kyla Nelson. 51-39. The FIU Panthers lead, and it's going to take some fight back from the Cats to get back into this one. But the hometown crowd believes they can do it. Here's Nelson. Long pitch out to Gonzalez, and then feeds around, and a three is good. Tanija Hayes hits one. It's a three-point party for FIU, and they were trying this all first half, and the threes weren't falling. They only hit 2 3-pointers in the first half, but they have come back now and hit 6 in the second so far. Into the lane, left-hand layup, good, and one. Excellent drive by Tania White, the senior forward from Sweetland, Maryland. White played for the same high school, Largo, in Maryland that produced former BCU head coach Vanessa Blair Lewis. A 2016 Maryland State basketball champion with Largo High School as well. Freshman year at Cookman, played in all 32 games. And the and one opportunity coming for White here. Swish, it's good. Two Whites on this Bethune-Cookman team. There's the freshman Kayla White and the senior Tania White. They are not related. And bumped out of bounds on the full court press by Imani Reed. And it'll be FIU ball. Reed, a junior from Columbia, Maryland and Hammond High School. Into a double team. Tanija Hayes passes out of it, then gets it back from Nelson. Nelson looking for a screen, finds it, but the switch is there. Contested three from Nelson. Offensive board by Gonzalez. Whistle underneath, and a foul on Bethune-Cookman. And they're going to get Tania White. And that'll be Tania White's third, I believe, as Imani Reed departs, replaced by Kayla Clark. FIU to inbound under the basket. It'll be Nelson the gunner. Nelson floats it up for the 6-3 Butera. And now Ekpeteta hands it back to her countrywoman. A three on the way. That was contested. No good. Excellent box out offensive board by Butera. But her layup is too strong, and the Cats come away with it. In transition, it'll be a three on the way from Tatum Hayes. Rolls out. Nelson with the easy board for FIU. Nelson through a maze of yellow jerseys. Offensive foul. The layup was good by Butera, but Nelson continued her run and charged in to Tania White, knocked her to the ground. And the Cats will get the ball. Down 42-54. Comeback not out of the question with just under 8 minutes to go. But they're gonna start having to hit shots. Nice ball movement in the backcourt to break the pressure from BCU that time. Here's White. Bounce pass underneath the basket. Tipped away and finally stolen. It was a nice passing idea to try and find Kayla Clark, but she couldn't hang on to the pass from Tatum Hayes. Underneath the basket, foul called, and to the line will go Hope Butera. So Morgan Beecham picks up her fourth foul. Be Beecham departs the game with 8 points, second in team scoring behind Kayla White with 10, but Kayla White had all 10 of those in the first half. She has been very effectively bottled up here in the second. As to the line again goes Butera. Butera misses it. Butera 3 of 4 from the free throw line before that. Now 3 of 5. 3 dribbles. And the long arms of Butera puts that one penalty shot too strong. Cats control with White. White around Gonzalez, gets to the baseline, tough runner, no good. Whistle underneath as Clark crashes to the ground. And they're gonna get Nelson with another foul. That's 3 on Nelson. And Jessica Burks Wiley, the head coach for FIU, is in the ear of the officials. He thinks that Clark initiated that contact by jumping in to Nelson. But the call goes the Wildcats' way and they get to inbound. Nice find by Hayes off the inbounds. Gonzalez guarding her. Zaida Gonzalez, no points tonight, but she has played some pretty key minutes defensively for FIU, and another travel. I believe that's the 4th for the Wildcats on the night. Rotating it around the edge into the middle for Torres, who just checked in for FIU. Baseline dribble drive, Gonzalez in and out off the rim. And the rebound is controlled by the ladies in yellow. And a blocking foul going to be called. And everybody wearing blue and gold is a little bit incredulous. They thought that was a charge. They're going to get it on Gonzalez. I mentioned off the top, second chance points were going to be huge because of the height advantage that FIU has overall. But 6 second chancers each way, that one even. Harris hands, gets her defender to fall down, and a long two doesn't go. Rebound, it's good for Kayla Clark. That was a good look to try and set that shot up. Originally for White, didn't go. Crashing the boards and getting a foul called is Emerald Ekpeteta off the miss from Gonzalez's original drive. Kayla White picks up her 2nd foul. Bethune-Cookman has started this 4th quarter well, 7-3 in the quarter, down by 10. But the free throw is piling up for FIU, another miss for the Golden Panthers. But they have done the majority of their damage tonight, both from the 3-point line and from the free throw line, as it's 0 of 2. Nice rebound by Clark, but it deflects out to the corner, and FIU controls and gets another possession whistle at a stoppage of play. And it looks like it's a clock issue. FIU, 14 of 21 from the charity stripe, as opposed to only 8 of 11 for Bethune-Cookman, and of course, 8 3-pointers for FIU, only 2 for the Wildcats. 6 minutes to go in the ball game, a 10-point deficit for BCU to try and overcome. FIU, the basketball, into the corner. 3 on the way, left it short, another offensive rebound. Floater in the lane, swish, it's good for Tanijah Hayes. Offensive rebounds 15-8 in favor of the Panthers. And that is really where they have shown their dominance on the glass, especially Hope Butera has done excellent work boxing out. But right now it's Torres in at the 5 for FIU. A pass under the basket trying to get to Clark is deflected out of bounds. by Olivia Trice. And Bethune-Cookman will keep it. Up next for Cookman are two road games to close out the calendar year. On the 19th, they're at Georgia Southern. And their final non-conference game is the 21st at Mercer. Their first ever SWAC conference game will be right here at Moore Gymnasium and can be seen on the Cat Eye Network on the 3rd of January as they face arch rival Florida A&M. As we wait for the floor to be dried to the referee's liking underneath the basket.
Eve, you ready to help? Eve, you ready to help on the X?
Tatum receives the inbounds pass. And now in the low post, a mid-range jumper comes in from White, and a whistle and a foul after the basket. It looks like they're going to pick up Torres. And that'll be Torres' second foul.
We're just trying to block out.
Her brother Alberto Torres plays college basketball at Iowa Wesleyan. That's an NAIA school, so basketball running in the family for the Torreses. Clark at the line for a 1+1, and she sinks the first one, as that's the fifth foul on the Panthers in the quarter. 10-point game, still 56-46 with 5:15 to go in the ball game. A trap comes in, and the ball is deflected off the foot of Tania White, and it will maintain with FIU. BCU playing very aggressively here. Again, the trap comes, and a foul is going to be called, and they're going to get Kayla White for the trip on Ferrer Bernard.
New clock, good.
In the ball comes to Hayes. Bernard still cycles around. Bernard gets it back, floats it into the front court for Ekpeteta, and FIU will settle down with 17 on the shot clock. Hayes around the Torres screen, kicks to the corner for Bernard. Thought about a three, won't take it. The three is all the way from Trice, and it's good. Olivia Trice up to 11 points with that three from the corner. And it's 59-46 FIU.
Rocky, gotta switch. Rocky, take
it. Into the paint, but no further goes Hayes. Hayes gets it back from a stopped up Harrell. Hayes, backdoor cutting pass with three on the clock, and a nice behind the back, or up and under lay-in with the left hand, from Kayla Clark. Long pass ahead finds Torres to break the Wildcat press, and BCU files back to defend their half court. A three on the way from Torres, bang, it's good! From Raquel Ferrer Bernard. Up to 14 points to lead all scorers for Bernard. And a nice assist on the perimeter passing. They gave the assist to Trice. We'll take the final media timeout. And when we come back, it's the final 3:36 between the Wildcats and the Panthers. This is Bethune-Cookman Women's Basketball on the Cat Eye Network.
Yeah.
Wildcat fans, you can catch all Bethune-Cookman home games on the Cat Eye Network. Go to youtube.com/user/Cat Eye Network. And we'll be on the air live tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Eastern as the Wildcats men's basketball team takes on the Johnson University Suns. Well, Florida International came into the game shooting 29.8% from three-point range as a team, and after only shooting 2 of 8 in the first half, they are now up to 10 of 27, 37% from beyond the arc tonight, and had that as well as their free throw shooting. They've been to the line for 21 shots, is really what has done in the Wildcats on the defensive side tonight. And they have done a very good job denying BCU access to the paint in the second half. And a lot of BCU's attempts have been difficult mid-range and outside shots. Here's a baseline run and a foul. No, a traveling violation and another turnover. The press comes from Bethune-Cookman, broken pretty easily by FIU. Just a little nice combination pass. And Tanaja Hayes controls. 3 minutes on the clock, 62-48. The lead for the FIU Panthers. Off a screen, a three on the way. It's good again from Olivia Trice. Into the corner, floated up towards the inside, and Clark sees it go off.
Hey, big stop!
I believe Ekpateta, and roll out of play. No, that was off of Trice, and out of play. Quickly into the corner for White. White in a tough spot, gets the ball away to Clark underneath. Nice defense by Torres. And FIU takes it away. In transition, Bernard in the corner. And FIU will slow it down, only needing to see out the remaining 2:13 to head back to Miami with a victory, and a reach in foul gonna be called. And it's gonna be two shots for FIU as BCU is in the bonus. It's been a group effort for FIU tonight. 14 points for Bernard, 14 points for Trice, 13 points for Ekpateta, and 11 points for Nelson as Torres is at the line. Sinks the first one, does the 6'1" Maria Torres. So the two top producers for each team have not really seen the floor a lot tonight. Ariel Colon averages 14.1 points per game for this FIU team. Saw a little bit of action in the first half, but has been on the bench for the entirety of the second half. She is wearing a knee brace on her left leg, so I wonder if there's a little bit of a injury recovery going on, which is limiting her minutes. Three on the way from BCU's leading scorer, Beecham. It's no good, but the putback is right in there from Tania White. I've been really impressed by Tania White, how she has attacked the basketball and attacked the rim, and BCU forces a turnover. Layup left it short, but a second chance opportunity comes for Beecham, and Beecham now up into double digits as she's got her 10th point of the night. 1:30 to go, 66-52. BCU started this quarter hot, but it is all even. 15-15 in quarter scoring between the Panthers and the Wildcats in this final frame. Seven to shoot for Bernard. Denies the screen, kicks it out for Trice, her three off the mark, but a long board comes back to Tanaja Hayes. Her putback is also no good, and the rebound is tapped away by Kayla Clark into the hands of White. White goes coast to coast, baseline runner rattles around and in, and FIU coach Birch Wiley wants a timeout. Birch Wiley in her second season with the Panthers. They are 20-16 on their way to 21-16 in two seasons with Birch Wiley at the helm. And as I mentioned all the way back at the top of the show, this Florida International team was just just 11, they won just 11 games over two seasons from fall 2018 to spring 2020. Jessica Burks Wiley has come in and completely turned this FIU program around to competing near the top of Conference USA. Last year, they won 8 Conference USA games, which are the most in team history since the Panthers joined from the Sun Belt in 2013. Up next for the Panthers, they are home at the Ocean Bank Convention Center in Miami for 2 games against Binghamton on the 20th and against UMass Lowell on the 21st. And then they start conference play with Old Dominion on the 30th of December. Under a minute to go, with the game seemingly well in hand for FIU, 66-54, scramble for the basketball and a jump ball. The possession arrow favors the Panthers, so they will keep it. But a little bit of a wayward pass there by Tanaja Hayes. Almost coughed the ball up. Just want to play sound basketball and get out of here in another 45.2 seconds. Hayes on top, guarded by Tatum Hayes for FIU, or for, excuse me, for BCU. Five on the shot clock. Trying to make space is Nelson. Nelson throws it up and gets fouled with 1 second to go. Surely that would have been a shot clock violation for FIU, but she just gets tapped on the arm by Amani Reed as she was trying to throw up a desperation heave. And Kayla Nelson is going to get a chance to add to her 13. In fact, if she hits both of these, she will go to the top of the FIU scoring charts with 15. Ferrer, Bernand, and Ekpeteta have 14 for FIU. And Bethune-Cookman's winless streak against Division I opposition continues. Their only wins against Division II Edward Waters and NAIA Warner, both in this building earlier in the season. But I think that the Wildcats and Coach Janelle Creighton can take a lot of confidence from this game. This is a very good FIU team that will challenge for the Conference USA title. And they held them. They were only down 2 at the break. And they have outperformed them in this fourth quarter. And really, it's only been one outlier quarter, the third, that FIU won 23-11. That has really been the difference in this game. Bethune-Cookman kept it close the other three quarters, and you play like this against an opposition that maybe is more your level at a conference level, and you're gonna win some games down the stretch, and we'll see. I believe the ceiling is very high for this Bethune-Cookman team this season. Tatum Hayes, 3, swish, it's good! With 12.7 to go to knock the deficit down to 10, with 12 to go, and Bethune-Cookman with foul with Kayla White. And so with that three-pointer from Hayes, Bethune-Cookman has matched their season average of 56.8 per game. And they will keep FIU to under their season opponent average of 72.6 in all likelihood, as Tanaja Hayes at the line for 2. Hayes, 6 points, second one no good. Fighting for the board, it's a scramble and it's another jump ball. This one will go to FIU as well with the possession arrow and just 8 seconds to go. To wrap up this one. So the former Florida International Sun Blazers, as the team was originally called in the 70s and 80s, changed to Golden Panthers in 1987, and the word Golden was officially dropped in 2011. We'll walk out of historic Moore Gymnasium tonight with a victory, as FIU will get the ball out of this timeout. Remember, once again, tomorrow night, 7 p.m., right here at Moore Gymnasium, it's the Bethune-Cookman men's basketball Wildcats taking on the Johnson University Suns. I will be here to provide you with the commentary and the Cat Eye Network to provide you with the visuals as it's an in-state battle as the Wildcats men's team looks to kickstart their season. All that action coming to your way live on YouTube on the Cat Eye Network. That's youtube.com/user/Cat Eye Network tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Eastern. So the scoreboard had it wrong. It will be Bethune-Cookman ball out of the held ball, and the Wildcats will have 8 seconds to do something with it. FIU bench calling for no foul here with the final 5 seconds. It'll be Tatum Hayes off a wayward pass, 4 seconds to go. She'll fire a three that's blocked. It's turned over, and that is your ball game. Your final score, Florida International Panthers 68, Bethune-Cookman Wildcats 57. Once again, it's 2 road games coming up for Bethune-Cookman to close out the calendar year at Georgia Southern on the 19th and at Mercer on the 21st, the first time the women's Wildcats will be back on RA waves here at the Cat Eye Network is the third of January as they host arch-rival Florida A&M to begin SWAC play. The Panthers of Florida International head home to face Binghamton and UMass Lowell as a part of the FIU Christmas Classic on the 20th and 21st. Here are your final line scores for this afternoon's contest. First for the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats. White was their top scorer with 12. That's Kayla White. Morgan Beecham had a below average 10. Tania White had 9. Harris had 7. Clark had 7. Williams had 6. Reed had 3. And Hayes had 3. That is the Cookman scores. And for the FIU Panthers, it was 4 in double digits for FIU tonight. Ferrer Bernard had 14. Trice had 14. Ekpeteta had 13. Nelson had 12. And the rest of the scorers, Hayes had 7. Torres had 3. Patera had 3. Cologne, their top scorer, had only 2, but I believe she is battling a knee injury. That'll be it from me. My name is Michael Trevillo, signing off from historic Moore Gymnasium. Once again, your final score, FIU 68. BCU 57, thank you so much for joining me on the Cat Eye Network tonight, and we will see you tomorrow for men's basketball.